Hello guys, Igor here, doing one more AppSumo review, today analyzing Dinorank, a tool that claims to optimizing your SEO content strategy with competitive keyword tracking. It's an SEO content strategy tool with a great focus on keyword tracking and research. It's not only a keyword tool, they have more features, being like more like an all-in-on SEO tool, and they claim to be an alternative to Ahrefs, SEMrush, and SE ranking. You can think also in Seo Audit that is right now on AppSumo. Dinorank helps you optimize your SEO strategy with keyword tracking, internal linking, competitors analysis, and more. Let's see how the deal works here. Is you're going to get all future pro plan updates. And the difference here will be the limit. If you buy a great tier, you get better limit. But since the tier one, the limit is good for the price, $69. And you get well-established SEO tool with 300 keywords to track, training domain tracking, and those features here that we're going to see each one here. For instance, keyword research is another great metric. You're going to get more keyword research monthly if you get a better tier. Here, I think the tier 2 is pretty good. Okay, if I decide to get that to write about the tier 1 to test it out and see if it works properly for me, and I'm enjoying it a lot. However, if I like it more, I'm gonna upgrade to tier 2. However, if you want to get even better limits, you have a tier 3 for 200 with more than 1,000 of keywords to track monthly. Let's take a look at the Dinorank. First of all, I wanna say that I loved the mascot that they have. The dino rank. I think they are the dino is pretty cool. And you can see here the main dashboard. The tool is divided by projects, and the project is a website that you're gonna use to track the keywords, etc. Before we analyze it too, I wanna say that they have a task manager session here where you can create it's like a project management for your SEO tasks. So you can create a task here and then monitor itself so you don't forget to do what you need to do to improve your SEO. Also, you have a control panel where you can see your website position, the number of URL that they crawled, also the stronger URLs inside inside your website. Okay, you can also see the history of your highest ranking keywords and the lowest ranking keywords, so the keyword that you lost position. So let's start to see each one of the tools that you're gonna find inside Dinorank. After you create a project, that I have one here, you're gonna create the project adding your website. And then you can change the country, change the language, and ask to analyze your websites. After that, you have a project and you can start to work with the tools that they have inside Dinorank. Here is the position tracking. It's where you're gonna monitor your keywords. You can see the limits here on top that you have up to 300 keywords. In my case, they're about the tier one. You can track those keywords by start date and end dates. You can view by cannibalizations or the keywords that you have highlighted. You can highlight keywords just clicking on that button here to highlight the keyword. It's highlighted as you can see here. And you can click again to, you know, do not highlight that anymore. You can track also by device, PC or mobile, and you can download the reports of your keywords as PDF or CSV. You can see your competition as well, comparing your keywords with your competitors. And here you can see the data that you're gonna get for a keyword, okay? For instance here, that keyword here has a volume of almost 1K, and my position here is 8. Okay, so I'm on the first page of Google for that keyword. That one with a volume of 40, I am the first one for that keyword. You can see when you are going up and down. For instance, here, it's a pretty huge keyword with more than 60K of research per month. And I have a really good position here with 54. Okay, I can even improve more my article to, you know, get a better position with that keyword. And if you want to add a new keyword, just click here, add keywords. You can add one per line. I'm going to add two keywords here. And you can choose to track both, or only desktop or only mobile. In that case, I'm going to track both. You can choose to group keywords in clusters. So you're going to analyze many more than one, more than two or three keywords inside a group. Okay, so you can create clusters here. And then you click on add keywords. Yes, I'm sure. You can see that they have added the keyword here and now they are getting the data. You will get also an evolution graph of your keywords. And that's a thing that's pretty cool on Dinorank. They have a lot of graphs you're going to see on the other tools. And you can set up alerts. You, let's say, choose one of the keywords, choose a comparator, better or equal, then and choose the position and add. And then you create an alert. If you lose rank or get a better rank, DinoRank will send a notification and you know what's happening with your preferred keywords. Then you also have an SEO audit on page. You can see your URLs without title, without H1, without meta description, duplicate titles, H1 duplicates, no index URLs, you can see slow URLs as well. You can see the here, and you can select, for instance, if you want to see the titles. So I have 8 duplicate titles to fix. I don't need to fix that. H1, so duplicate H1, without H1, so you can see the page that you don't have an H1, and then you can fix it. You can take a look at the meta description if you have duplicate meta descriptions or no meta description. You can see your mirror URLs, slow URLs. So those are the URLs that they think they're slow. Okay, you can improve it. For instance, you know, if you are embedding a lot of things in that URL, just take off the embed stuff. And you get also a report of the SEO audit on page analysis. It is a PDF. Okay, you can download clicking on that button here. The report is like about all those data here and those here. Okay, here they will identify the semantic prominence of your blog articles. Okay, so they will give data for you to improve your ranking. For that, you need to add the keywords and you may or may not add the URL to be positioned, but the tool will find the URLs that are relevant for those keywords. So you can also just add the URL and click on analyze, or also use the add the URL that you want to analyze related to that keyword. As you can see here, the monthly limit for that tool is 225 analysis per month. Here you can see the most important words, the ones that are prominent to rank for that keyword here. So you can see many keywords here, many, you know, words that you should use on your article because they are prominent. And then you can analyze the prominence, the semantic prominence, of that, of each article with the keyword. So that would be the likelihood of those websites to rank on Google. As you can see here, they found my blog post about that without the need of me adding the URL. And they gave me the prominence of 8-10. So I'm almost perfect for that article here. You can see here the keywords that are relevant to rank about that subject. Not so easy to understand that part. I think I need to study a little bit more to go more in depth. Oh, likely what I have said. The tool indicates the list of the most important words that you have to take into account when developing your content to rank for that keyword. So the words are here. You need to have those words on your blog post. Here is their keyword research feature. As you can see on tier one, you have 150 keyword research per month. You can just choose the country, the language, and here United States and English. Let's research about Facebook Reels. As I said, the tool has a lot of graphics that help you to understand what's happening. And you can see here the trend. So with month, you have more research about that subject. And you're gonna get the keywords that are related to Facebook Reels. You get Facebook Reels here, the volume search, the competition, and the CPC. And then you get the related keywords. Reels on Facebook, what's Reels on Facebook, how to share Instagram Reels to Facebook, and the volume here, also the difficulty. I like the way that they dispose the related keywords. Okay, you can see that the keyword research is relevant. You can export a CSV or copy the selection. If you click here, you can see the trend of each keyword. I can see that keyword research being pretty useful for me. Then you have the Dinorank internal PR. So here you can see the URLs that are stronger, you know, and because of the internal linking building, you can see those that are stronger and the ones that are, you know, more weak is what you see in that graphic. When the circle is bigger, the URL is stronger, like this one and that one. In that graphic here, you can see your internal link being building here in the middle. You're going to see your homepage, and then you can see your link building, the categories, how your site is structured. You can also avoid to track the subdomains. It will be better for you and for me. So if you want to do not track the subdomain, just go here. Do not track other subdomains and retracking projects. You have a monthly limit of 20 tracking per month on tier one. So here you can check your organic traffic. For that, you need to synchronize your Google Analytics and Search Console account. You just synchronize it with a click of a button. It's pretty simple. After you synchronize your organic traffic, you have the keyword opportunity feature and analyze positioned keywords. That one, you just pass the URL that you want to search, the position of that keyword, and click on search. Then you're going to see the keywords that you are ranking for in that URL. I have 12 on that one and 7 on that one. You can click here to see all keywords. So you can see all your keywords according to Google Analytics and also the clicks that you're going to have, that you are having for that keyword. So you can find keywords that you didn't know that you were ranking for. I'm seeing a lot of different keywords here. This is really, really, really interesting. That this feature sold me. I'm finding a lot of keywords that I didn't know, okay? But this is gold. This is really gold, okay? You can also click on keywords opportunities and the tool will just see which keywords you can improve on your blog post. You click here for tips, and they will say, just add the title tag like that, include H1 like that, include H2 like that. They are adding the anchor text like that. That's the cannibalization feature. You can see that I have some tools cannibalizing me. What happened here? They will detect when your website is like competing with two different URLs for this to get the same position on Google. And then Google will not know which one they will position as the first one. So you need to solve that conflict and then you will better position your URL. As you can see, I have a lot of things to do with my keywords. For instance, here, I may take off that anchor text here to improve, to stop the cannibalization and improve my ranking factor. You will receive also tips to solve the cannibalization issue. So they will tell you what you need to do to stop the cannibalization. This is also gold. And I've never found, I don't have other tool that does that kind of thing. And here you will add a URL and they will give you a visibility graph with your ranked keywords. You can see here, there's a monthly limit of 35 per month in the tier one. That's why I think I'm going to get for sure the tier two. You click here to analyze. They finished the analysis and you can see here the estimated traffic per month. I got a really good growth here, really good evolution this year. And you're going to see the main keywords positioned for my domain. That's so much gold. This is gold. You can see the better ones, where I'm getting traffic, how I'm getting traffic from those keywords. Okay. You can download that as a CSV and you can check the each URL that you're getting traffic from. The other tool is theme content detection. It's another tool that you need to synchronize your Google Analytics and Search Console. You're going to see the URLs that you are not getting traffic from. I did not receive any organic traffic between June and August on those URLs. So those URLs are not working. Nobody's, you know, are reading those contents. You can see here the contents that are working and the other ones that are not working. So the ones that are ranking and the ones that aren't ranking. This is gold. This is gold. It's also features that I don't have in on other SEO tools. So for me, I'm going to keep in Dinorank because they are giving me new data to improve my SEO strategies. The external linkage management is your backlinking monitoring, but it's manual. You're going to add the links, the backlinks that you want Dinorank to track. And Dinorank will track your backlinks. And if you lose a backlink, Dinorank will warn you. You will alert you that you have lost that backlink. So that's the last tool. Overall, I think I'm amazing. I think I like it so much. And I'm likely improving, if I have the money, the tool to the tier two. It's a good tool. It's established. One can say that they know what they are doing. The data is complex and at the same time, it's useful. We can use those tools to really understand your website and how to improve them. And also to think about which kind of keywords that you can use to improve your website even more. I think that for one website, the limits to the tier two is okay. You can work with that. And this can be one of your best AppSumo deals. And it will, of course, improve your SEO strategy. I think Dinorank is a no-brainer and 5 takeaways. You can buy it. Just get it. It's a nice tool. On the next review, I'm going to compare SEO Audit and Dinorank to see if we need to keep both or choose one of them. So let's compare Dinorank and SEO Audit until, you know, tomorrow. I hope you like that review. If you like, please click on the link in the description to help me to keep going. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.